Welcome back to Playa del Carmen, Mexico, and another seaweed video update. We're gonna go down to the beach this morning at sunrise, and we're gonna watch the workers clean up the beach. It looks like it's official now that tourism is being affected by the seaweed. Also, the real estate market with condo sales, Airbnb sales, house sales down here are also being affected. Welcome back to my channel and welcome to Playa del Carmen, Mexico. Here is my typical morning sunrise down at the beach. Here are some workers and here is the process. Every morning you wake up, it's basically a stink. It stinks on the beach. Now if you're staying at the Hyatt or the Hilton or one of these all-inclusive five-star resorts right on the water, this is what you're going to wake up to. You're gonna wake up to a nice sunrise, you can hear the waves, but you're gonna have this stink and you're going to have this seaweed. Now what happens is right at sunrise, you have a number of workers that will come out and they will put the seaweed, they'll dig the seaweed, and you'll watch them do it during this video. They'll put it in this kind of long, thin line as close to the water as possible. Then this blue tractor comes along and it drives over it, and it has a special kind of apparatus at the back that picks all this seaweed up. And it will go to the end of the beach as close to a road, wherever you're staying, it'll go as close to a road as possible, and it will dump what it's just picked up into a big pile. Now from there, that big pile will sit there and this huge yellow tractor will come and it will pick up, it's a front loader, it'll pick up as much as it can, it will drive out onto the closest road and put it into a big white bin. It will fill that white bin and then a truck will come, pick up that bin, or put down one bin, pick up that bin and go. Now this goes on basically from sunrise, and I've been following it for the last 3 months until about 11 in the morning. So if you're coming down to the beach, come down to the beach after 11 a.m. and a lot of the seaweed will be gone. Now I'm not saying the seaweed in the water will be gone, it'll still be in there, and now the water is brown. When I got here in January it was a nice Caribbean blue, it's brown now. So you probably won't be able to go in the water, but you'll see that the beach is pretty clear of the seaweed. And this happens every morning. And like I said, if you're staying at one of these five-star resorts right on the beach, this is what you're going to wake up to. Every morning, there is yoga on the beach down the way. There are people meditating on the beach. There's people working out on the beach. If you're one of these people that likes to get up at sunrise and get out on the beach, I just want to let you know, this is what you're going to be seeing. It is not a pristine, quiet environment. You've got the beep, beep, beep of all these kind of tractors going up and down the beach. And can you really walk on the beach? Well, you'll be able to walk kind of away from the water, but you're going to have tractors going up and down the beach trying to pick this stuff up between sunrise, let's just say between 6:30 and 11 in the morning. So beaches, mornings on the beach really are a no-go anymore. I come down, I'm a sunrise guy, I love coming down here, and then I'll come down around 5 and I'll stay on the beach till sunset. So sunset is okay because most of the seaweed's gone, but sunrise, when you think you'd have a really content, quiet, zen type of moment with nature, listening to the waves, it's not happening. One good thing that I can report on is like the last month, the seaweed has not really gotten much worse. Now, certain parts along Playa, certain beaches will be worse than others some days. Some days you'll get it, it's pretty good. But I think what this is really affecting now, it's affecting tourism. And they're saying between April and August, it's supposed to be the worst. Talking about putting the barriers out there. I guess it's going to be next week. The other thing is that a number of people are down here to buy, whether it be a condo or a cheap place, so they can come down here for a number of months. I guess I'm just gonna say, you know, I had the same idea. You come down here, maybe you can get a nice condo for $100,000. You're down in Playa, if you're down here for a number of months, and the weather's great. Now, I'm seeing a lot of people change their mind. They're saying, no, we're not gonna buy in Playa. The issue is, this seaweed is everywhere now. It is now up in Florida on the East Coast. You've got red tide in the Gulf, which is probably even worse for your health. Anywhere through the Caribbean, there is a whole bunch of this seaweed now. A lot of people are heading over to the West Coast, Puerto Vallarta, and that area because there's no seaweed over there. But maybe sometimes you've got issues with safety over there. So I guess what I'm hearing is people are saying they're rethinking their plans. They're not gonna buy. People are just saying buyer beware. And there has been a mass exodus the last month. People are leaving Playa and they're going to other places, especially the digital nomads. They're going to another beach somewhere else with better weather, and there's no seaweed. Now there's a bunch of pros and cons for coming to Playa. And the other thing I'm hearing is that a lot of people are going to come down earlier next year. I said that in the last video. So will we come back? If we do come back, we're coming back probably November, December, January, and maybe February we'll leave. You can't swim really in the water now, and they're saying there's more seaweed to come. This is my seaweed update number 8 video, I believe. And it is a huge issue in the news right now, especially in North America and the Caribbean area. NBC contacted me early last week. They asked if they could use some of the footage of the previous videos I've put out while walking along the beach. CNN, I did a phone interview with them that we talked about the situation in Playa with the seaweed. The New York Times quoted me last week regarding the seaweed issue here too. So it is a huge issue. It's affecting tourism. I just think about the prices of real estate. We're probably gonna have to go down. Condos, Airbnbs will likely go down with all this publicity about the seaweed and how it's stinky and how it's not really enjoyable. But other than that, it's been great weather. It's only rained one day, and that was one afternoon in the number of months we've been here. I still think bang for your buck, you can get an awesome place here near the beach. If you're looking to come down here and escape the cold, whether it be buying or renting or an Airbnb, I still think this is bang for your buck. It is a great place to come. Also, there's great people here. A lot of them are pretty transient, digital nomads going in and out, YouTubers kind of coming in and out, snowbirds in and out, but it has been super social. We've really enjoyed it. But they have to do something in Playa, the Caribbean, Florida, with all this seaweed. They're gonna have to find a remedy and do something. I just wanna say thanks to all the YouTubers, digital nomads, all the snowbirds kind of I've met around here. I don't really have too much bad to say about Playa. I think it's a great location. I feel safe, great people, great food, great restaurants, great bang for your buck. I would probably not come back here between April and August when the seaweed's allegedly at its worst. I will probably look at other options for next year. All in all, I'm gonna say I've really enjoyed it. And the seaweed is something that's new and it's getting worse and worse, and it will probably drive tourism away. Hopefully, there's millions of dollars being spent on this issue. Hopefully they can look for a remedy and make the beaches better. I'm gonna conclude this. I'm just gonna say thanks for coming along today and just watching the video. And I'm gonna say, hopefully I see you next week, but I'm just gonna say ciao for now.